In the beginning of June, I set out for a quest to learn Japanese every single day for at least 5 hours for the entire summer. The first 3 days were a bit more difficult than I expected, but after a few weeks and having finally figured out what's the best way to go about those 5 hours, I eventually got used to it and I'm confident that I can keep this up until the summer ends. And it's already been about 2 months since I got started, and so far, combining immersion and direct study, I have a little over 200 hours of learning clocked in. Which essentially means that compared to studying only 1 hour a day, in only around 50 days, I've already gained over half a year's worth of experience. Well, actually, I don't think it's as simple as saying that I'm half a year better than I was before, already because it's too hard to tell. My Japanese has reached a level where I definitely still don't feel fluent, but making progress is becoming increasingly difficult to notice. So while I do have days where I'm not sure whether or not I'm making any progress, when I think about it, I feel like now I know so many seemingly fundamental things that I didn't know less than 2 months ago. I think the biggest issue with my Japanese still seems to be the lack of vocabulary. Despite me theoretically knowing over 6,000 words, I feel like I want to know at least double that, which means that the most valuable thing I can do right now is to learn as many new words and expressions as I can, which I've been trying to do at the rate of 10 to 15 new Anki cars per day. It may not seem like a lot, and I mean, after all, I took about the same amount with a pre-made deck back when I was only studying for about 1 hour a day. But the thing is, now I'm using sentence cards that I create from my immersion, and for me, a single sentence card takes much more time to review than a vocabulary card, especially considering that I might have multiple new words in a single card. I also like that I can practice reading just by doing Anki. In fact, it feels as if my reading has gotten faster compared to a few months ago, despite me actually not having done that much dedicated reading. Also, thanks to the sentences, I can learn words and especially expressions that are really hard to learn without any context. And I seem to get better retention rate compared to vocabulary cards, which makes Anki a bit less frustrating of an experience. In total, I've made about 500 cards by now, and averaged about 5.3 hours of learning per day, including Anki. Which means that I'm still on schedule, but there are days where I didn't hit the full 5 hours, as life occasionally got in the way. However, if I feel that it's necessary, then I'll probably extend this challenge by another week at the end of the summer to make up for all the days where I didn't hit my goals. One of the things I realized pretty much right away was that I'm not going to be able to do everything I planned in a single day. In the announcement video, I said that I'm going to be doing reading, listening, speaking, and writing all in one day, every single day. And even in an update video on my second channel, I said that I'd be sentence mining daily for another 2 hours as well. But it seems that the only viable option for me is to immerse with whatever works for that specific day, as I might not feel like it, nor have the opportunity to do everything literally every single day. So instead, my two primary activities have been watching content as well as passive, or rather semi-passive, listening. In total, I've listened to at least 80 hours of podcasts, mostly whilst exercising, doing errands, and so on. And I think the main benefit I've gotten from them is that when you hear the same people talk for so many hours, you start picking up their speech patterns yourself. And in general, I feel like it's a nice change of pace to do some immersion that's not behind the screen. While I think that only doing sentence mining for 5 hours a day will definitely yield the best results for me, it also gets extremely exhausting really quickly, especially if you need to use screens outside of immersion pretty much all day as well. So, for using my time wisely without burning myself out, passively listening to podcasts ended up being the best option for me. When it comes to watching stuff, such as anime and movies, I prefer using Japanese subtitles so I could sentence mine from them as well as to increase my comprehension. And in general, I just prefer watching stuff with subtitles. Even for English content, I like using English subtitles so I wouldn't miss any dialogue. Essentially, I want to eliminate all ambiguity to make sure I understand the plot as well as possible. Now, this is kind of problematic when it comes to learning a language, as tolerating ambiguity is a big part of immersion. If I'm watching something that I couldn't find Japanese subtitles, if I'm really starting to get into it, I end up constantly wanting to turn on the English subtitles, even if I understand what's going on just through listening. But well, I mean, as long as you try to pay as much attention to the Japanese as you can, and then later check the English subtitles if you were uncertain about something, I think it's totally fine and can be beneficial, but just try not to forget to turn them back off. Another thing I want to talk about is outputting. I know I said that I'm going to be outputting daily, but I actually have barely done any output practice at all. I did try it, and it was rather difficult because while I did have a pretty wide vocabulary that I could use, due to the lack of practice, sentences often ended up being kind of wonky and unnatural. And during conversations, I was sometimes a bit inconsistent with things such as polite and casual speech patterns. Also, trying spoken conversation for the first time kind of felt like when someone asks you to say something in a language that you're learning, and suddenly you forget every word that you had learned. So while I think that getting input is great for building a baseline for outputting, and while I think I could still benefit a lot from getting more input, you definitely have to practice outputting if you want to get good at forming and recalling sentences to sound natural. Unfortunately, right now, it's really inconvenient for me to get daily output practice, so I've put it on hold for now. But I'll probably get back into it in the upcoming months. Originally, I was planning on making 3 update videos here on the main channel about this epic summer plan, one at the end of every month, but I decided that instead I'll make only this video and then I'll wrap it up in the finale once I hit 3 years of learning, where I'll also try to finally benchmark my Japanese and show the results. So I guess I'll see you there, and oh yeah, one more thing. This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Now, I know you've already seen my previous sponsored video, and in that case, you should already know that Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creators. You can explore new skills, deepen existing passions, and lose yourself in the creativities. And because Skillshare is curated specifically for learning, unlike this video, there are no ads. And they're of course always launching new premium classes, so you can keep your eye on the horizon and follow your creativity wherever it takes you. You can get started with investing, animation, writing, or whatever else your heart desires. And me, personally? Well, I just beat Ninja at his own game after becoming a professional builder thanks to the complete guide to building in Fortnite. And after taking this class, I now know some crazy tactics to build up various different 90 degree towers to ramp up my victories on the battlefield. Thanks, rank up courses. Oh yeah, and did I already mention that with a subscription you can explore literally any class you want? And if you're still not really sure whether or not it's worth it for you, well, the good thing is that the first 1000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free trial of premium membership for an entire month. So you too could explore your creativity.